Hi Harsh, good morning.
Very good morning, ma'am.
Welcome to your first mock PI.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Excited?
Yeah, for sure, ma'am.
Wonderful. Okay. So I'll just quickly introduce the panelists. We'll be taking a mock interview today. So we have Purva, ma'am. She's our academic head of PEHEL.
Okay.
And we have Vishal, sir. He's a management expert, also a director of PEHEL organization. Okay. So I would request Purva ma'am to please start the interview.
Yes, ma'am.
Good morning, Harsh. How are you?
Very good morning, ma'am. I'm all good.
Okay. Harsh, tell me something about yourself.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I'm Harsh Verma. I hail from the Manchester city of North India, that is Kanpur. It is very famous for its leather work, equally for its textile industries. I come from a nuclear family, including me, my sister, and of course my parents. Uniquely adding to my education, I have done my Bachelor in Arts from a reputed college in Kanpur. And I'm very fond of esports, which I believe will be going to be included in Olympics as well. Moreover, I like to play chess as well. I don't like adventure sports because I'm a quite bit of acrophobic. And I aim to become a very successful person with a lot of hard work and determination. And my strength evolves around being very generous and passionate about my work with the ideology of working with honesty towards the task given to me.
Okay, Harsh.
Yes, ma'am.
Harsh, how you define success in life?
Success in life, according to me, ma'am, is something
Okay, Harsh, you're shortlisted for which course?
Ma'am, MFM.
MFM, okay.
Yes.
So why you want to go for MFM?
Because I believe MFM has vast and varied opportunities as compared to other platforms. According to me, this is the best platform I can have in my life. And that's it, ma'am.
What kind of opportunity you're expecting after completing MFM course?
I'm expecting opportunities which are definitely going to show my personality out of the crowd, which I believe like many people are going towards BTech and MBBS. And being myself as a BTech dropout, that's the reason I dropped out of BTech and wanted to pursue MFM in future. So here's my chance and here I am in front of you, ma'am.
So in which course you have done your graduation?
I'm Bachelor of Arts.
So what learning would you like to take from your graduation to your master's?
Like to be very passionate about your career and whatever life throws in front of you, don't hesitate, face every challenge and keep a smile.
No, Harsh, I asked what learning would you like to take from your graduation, you know, knowledge to the master's?
Okay, yeah. Sorry, ma'am. Sorry. Learning part I consider to be I'm sorry, ma'am.
Okay, no problem, Harsh. Thank you. Over to you, sir.
Hi, Harsh. How are you?
Very good morning, sir. I'm good. I'm fine.
Great. So, like, why MFM? Why you want to go pursue this course?
So, I feel MFM is the best opportunity for me. I know there are many other opportunities available
mm-hmm.
as well.
Mm-hmm.
But I prefer MFM just because I wanted to pursue it from the right point of life when I got my graduation. And when my parents didn't support me, I always wanted to go for MFM. And in my bachelor's as well, I wanted to pursue my graduation from NIFT. But due to some personal reasons and financial crisis, I wasn't able to. So when I got my shot in my life, according to what life throws in front of you, definitely went for MFM.
Okay, great. So do you have any idea what kind of career opportunity that you have after pursuing MFM?
Yes, there are many career opportunities in the merchandising sector, which I am definitely planning to go for, like product manager, liaison officer, production manager, as well as fashion forecaster. And personally, I am very much fascinated about the term cool hunter. Yes, sir.
Okay, what do you mean by cool hunter?
A cool hunter is a person who is a forecaster of fashion, who basically travels from one country to places or whatever the task has been assigned to him or her. Basically, for example, if a travel blogger uploads a video of hidden gems of some place, but the cool hunter is a person who will be knowing these things even before anyone knows. Like he will be, yes, sir. Yes,
okay, great. Okay, great. So, Harsh, what is your family and how, like, can you just brief idea about your family?
So, I come from a nuclear family again. My younger sister, my father is a government employee and my mother is a homemaker.
Okay. Do you have, how the textile industry in India is doing? Do you have any idea about what kind of growth and what is the contribution in GDP of Indian economy?
Yes, sir. Textile industry contributes 2% in its total GDP, 16% when provides its employment, and 7 to 8% to its financial growth.
Is it the latest figure that you are talking about, or like?
Yes, it's the latest figure. According to my knowledge, it is the latest figure. Yes.
Okay. So, which country is doing better in for this textile industry? Which has a better, country is leading in this?
China, sir. That's because they are vast and very ahead of us in terms of technology. We do have labor force, but we can't compete with them in terms of technology. That's why.
Can you quickly do the SWOT analysis of textile industry?
May I beg your pardon, sir?
Can you in India, what is the strength and weakness of textile industry?
Okay, thank you, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Coming to strengths, textile industry have a very varied culture. Like we haven't explored even, I believe, 10% of our textile industry, as because there are many things which are lacking in terms of handicrafts, exports, and there are many things which haven't been discovered yet. And these are the negative points which I believe, if they are going to be kept in mind, textile industry sooner will have its level more than, like it will be contribute more than 2% to the GDPI, and it will provide more and much better employment to the people of the country. And positive
point. Great.
And coming to the positive, yes, sir.
Yeah, please continue.
And coming to the positive points, I believe like textile industry is doing good, but not that good. But yeah, it could be just because we haven't focused on it. And although it is providing many job opportunities to the people, but I believe it will definitely going to do great and good if some like people are youth like us going to do startup in this field as well. Like people have been starting up their startups in technology and technical terms. But I believe like if I were given a chance, I will definitely going to give a boon to this boost as well to this textile industry.
Okay, great. Purva, now I'm done with all the questions. So like you can continue the feedback, yes.
Harsh, I have one question to ask that do you know any what kind of specialization would you like to do in your MFM?
I would like to go for merchandising. Merchandising.
And do you know in MFM how many specialization you can go for it? And is there merchandising is available as or not? Yeah, tell me. Matlab, you need to tell me what is DS1, DS2 and DS3.
I don't know what is DS1, DS2 and DS3. Like I haven't gone through, but I do know about the MFM part, that merchandising part, it is product manager.
But I'm asking about the specialization, especially. What kind?
That I don't know. That I haven't gone to yet.
Okay, good. Coming to your feedback, Harsh, first of all, you need to set your camera, which is more towards your face, right? Because I can't see your whether you have an eye contact or not, because you are at very distant of the, I think, from the camera, right? So first you need to check your position, like mm-hmm. check it before coming for a mock, right?
Mm-hmm.
First is this. Harshal, in some of the question you in the introduction you have said I don't like this. So in the introduction I must say, try to highlight quickly what are the important points you want to put. So seeing what you don't like, it's, I think it can be put at the end, or it can, it not need to be mentioned in the introduction at all.
Okay, ma'am.
Right. So what you like, what is your, okay, whatever you like, how you inspired to come in a design industry, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you not need to mention unnecessary until unless all that you are being from dropout from the engineering and all. Kisi ne pucha to nahi, you do not need to mention it, right? So first thing is that success is something you already mentioned, you want to be a successful person. But what does success means to you? I was not very clear about it.
Yes,
and I'm sure you was also not prepared for it.
Yeah.
So carefully choose your word in your answers, right? Be careful about it, because at least we should tell you that at least we can expect that you, whatever words you are using, you know the meaning for yourself.
Yes, ma'am. Absolutely.
Right. I have faced certain thing like you have not listening the question properly. You know, you have a set of answer which is prepared back of your mind, and whatever question is being said, you want to put that answers, right? So don't fit answers, right?
Okay.
Try to listen the question and then tell whatever you are, like, you know, whatever you know about it. And I'm sure you know the yourself the best.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when I've said why MFM, it was a very generalized answer. Even sir was also asked about the same, but the same answer being repeated, which was very generalized. So I'll tell you, the interview panel won't able to give you so much time. You know, if they felt you're not prepared, they'll move to the other question. Okay. Now, when somebody asks about your family and all, so just, you just finished in two lines. So there was nothing that is you have inherent from your family, or you felt a proud of your family, or something value addition there should be, right? So I feel your pitch was very flat. Okay, whatever being question asked, it was same kind of pitch was there to give the answers. Now I'll suggest you, Harsh, please read the brochure. Okay, there is actually clearly mentioned what are the specialization you can do in your MFM.
Yes,
there are three kind of specialization, but I want you to read the brochure first. Okay. I can give you the last piece of suggestion is that, or advice that you need a very much mirror practice. You can make a chit of questions which you think the interviewer can ask, in the panelist can ask to you. You put in a bowl, pick one answer sheet from that, sit in front of mirror, answer the question, and see how your body language, how your confidence, how your voice, because I felt somewhere lack of confidence as well. I don't know whether you prepared for it or not. Even if you're not prepared, you know, it's okay. If you can try for the answer, you can say it, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Harsh, so you need to work on that part, I'll say. Okay. Thank you so much. Over to you, sir.
Yeah. Hi, Harsh.
Hello, sir.
Yeah. Comfortable?
Yes, absolutely. I have seen you in many videos as well. Like before.
Okay. Great. So I generally come join very few interviews, but yes, good that you have seen my videos. That's really great. Yeah. Harsh, the one thing, something good about you is that you are answering every question. That is a good sign, you know, at least you read a lot. Because I ask you a few questions which are related to subject, and you had a given at least figure, the figure you talked about. It means you have gone through a industry knowledge, you have learned about it. So those are very good signs. And also, you are not like you are continuing with your words. This shows, you know, you are trying to perform better. You are trying to perform best. But again, now these are the good sign of yours. Now, I'll come to some few feedback which will be which will definitely help you out to come out with these small things which I'll share with you. First thing, we are here to interact with each other. Fine. We are not more interested that what you are answering, how you are responding to that particular question. And we want to check that the way you respond to the question that we are asking, first thing. Second thing is you don't need to frame out anything. You don't need to remember, you know, I have to speak in this, I have to introduce myself in that way. I have to introduce myself or in this way. You have to be very interactive. Right? If you ask me, suppose you ask me, sir, tell me about yourself. Then I'll start, hi, this is Vishal. I love traveling. I have been to many country and I have been through every corner of India. I'll be very, I'll be not in frame. I did my engineering. I work with L&T. Then you have to very like, you know, every time someone asks you about you, so you have to be different every time. If I ask, like ma'am has asked you, you know, why MFM, and then you, when you are answering me, now, then you have to be very different. Okay, the same words can be said in different ways. Fine.
Yes.
So you always don't have to repeat the same paragraph, same the way you have explained to mom. Ma'am. So you need to understand few things. Fine. Now, when you are talking about the industry, when you are talking about certain things, so it seems that you have some structured, you are restricting something in your word. Do not do that, because that shows, you know, you are not confident. See, at this moment, it is good that you are trying to be something like that, but that should not reflect to the interview panel. You have to very natural, you have to very comfortable, and you have to very confident. These are the very first sign. And when you are introducing yourself, then you have to very special about you, you know, how I am different from others. Otherwise, the same, everyone does engineering or everyone does graduation without, they don't come for this. So what is something that you have a very different about, why they will give you a better marks? So you need to work on small things. Otherwise, and the way we are sitting, you have to also sit in this way. Do not come with a complete body gesture and because you sit on table and keep your mobile or laptop, whatever, on table, and proper lighting should be there, and your face should be visible, because we are not able to see your eyes, because I can see the, this is a passport size photograph kind of, no? You have to sit like this one, so that we can make an eye contact and we can understand the way your eye movement is, the way you are moving your hand. But do not do the excess of anything. You are moving hand like this. It seems that you are dancing. So everything should be in limit. Fine. So that is a requirement. But I have a good hope that you can perform better. But work on this. Be natural. Don't try to be...
Okay, sir.
You are sitting in interview. Don't try to be like this. Fine.
Okay,
understood. Don't try. Be natural and confident. Confident will come, and keep a smile on your face. Don't be so serious about it.
So sorry for interrupting. So there's a one question on my mind. Like, you got it absolutely right that I have been being something confident, something I wasn't. So, so you told me that being natural, and so if I ask you for a question, so please introduce yourself. So please, can you give me an introduction yourself? So I can perform in that way. Or
when, I can. I can. I introduce myself. Hi, this is Vishal Singh, and I did my MBA from Pune University, Pumba, and I was working with CRS Technology Private Limited. I have 11 years experience in marketing technology, and with now it's more than 10 years in education also. I'm an engineer in computer science, and I work with L&T after doing my engineering. Yes. And if I talk about my passion, I love traveling and meeting with the new people, and just every day meeting with that makes me confident, and that makes me happy. Knowing a different culture and moving, going through across world and going through across country, that makes me happy. So my idea of living this life is to be happy. And I believe that being happy is not all about money. It is all about you had a good company of your friends. You have a good environment. You have this is the way that you can explain. Do not get into something which makes you see. If you ask me next time, I'll be different. I'm not going to be the same every time, because see, first you need to understand who am I. Fine, you need to understand who am I. Write 3 or 4 pages about you. What makes me happy? What makes me sad? When I feel low in my life, then what I do? Fine. So once you write 4 or 5 pages about yourself, not one page or one paragraph, then you can start from anywhere. But again, you'll have to understand, you have to talk about something which is relevant and which will define you in that way. Fine. It is not all about I'm just more interested for your education. I'm also interested as a human being, how you are different from others.
Okay.
What is your passion in life? Because you are coming for NIFT or MFM, then you'll have to also just include this key, why MFM you are coming for this. So you have to relate with some hobbies or interest, and this I want to work for. I'm more inclined towards fashion. So when I thought about the management, then NIFT was the obvious. You talk about like this, fine.
Okay.
So in this way,
sorry, sir.
But you need to write down first 5 or 6 pages about yourself. What my family is all about, what I have learned from them, as Purva ma'am said, what you have inherited from them. If my father, how he supported me in my life, how my mother supported, what my siblings are, how, what kind of importance they have. So once you know about everyone, once you know about it, start from yourself, then come to your family, then come to your friends. For me, life is to be with my friends, and like whatever you actually feel it and enjoy it, you have to explain that. Fine. Do not get into words and do not get into a structure.
Yes, absolutely, sir.
So fine, you need to write about yourself. Fine. Sir, and again, yes.
Sir, I have been answering in a form of structure, I guess, like I believe. So you are actually, interviews all about interaction. I can put whatever point I want to put first. Like after my introduction, I come to my family. Not worry that I should talk about my likes and dislikes after that, or it's not in a structure point of view.
Yeah, whatever. No, I'm not saying, what I'm saying that don't be so serious. See, if I remember something, first I have to say that my name is Vishal Singh. Then I have to talk about graduation. I have to talk about my education. Then I have to talk about my hobbies. Then I have to talk about my family. Then I have to, where I have worked. Do not start with your present, that what you are doing at this moment. Then come to the past. You know what you are doing at this moment. Fine. Then you come to the rest of the things. Fine.
Okay,
what
sir.
My point?
Yes,
so
sir.
That's, it will come gradually. What's your interview date, Harsh?
Sir, 1st of May.
Oh, it's a long time that you get ready with all the small things. And I think you have potential, but you need to work on these things.
Yes,
fine?
For sure.
Okay, Harsh, all the best. Okay, bye. Take care.
Thank you, Harsh. I hope you work on the points that the panelists have highlighted. For as of now, you can leave the meeting. We'll get in touch with you for the next mock PI.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you.